because Powers gave them up to vile affections, for even their woman did change the natural use into that which is against nature.
Let's be honest, sir. And it's not a coincidence that this recorded in the Book of Romans. Because that was the customs of the Romans. They used to do all kind of vile shit. Because that was Edomites. And that is why this recorded in the Book of Romans. And they had Jake going off doing all kind of vile shit. Let's be honest, sir. Paul even go and speak about the next thing. Go ahead.
It says, and likewise also, the men leaving the natural use of the woman, burnt in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meet.
Yes, it was meet. So, the recompense of the error, which was meet, that's why a lot of you homosexuals get your rot, just be rotten enough, just get anal infection and all of that, because you're not supposed to do these things.
Most I give them up to that
cat.
Most I put those infections and all the diseases and that
cat. You get these diseases
because you most I put them up.
You ain't supposed to do that. That is error. That is the way of error. You understand? The way of righteousness is right here. That is scripture say, wisdom cried in the streets. This is the way of righteousness. Repent, telling the nation of Israel to return and repent and come back to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. You understand? And this is not a new work either. This is not something just new. The prophets of the Lord been always outside on the streets. From ever since, in the creation of time. They've been away. You understand? That way the scripture says, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophet since the world began. Prophets always was out there. Every time I empire the fall, there's a prophet rising up to prophesy the destruction that will come. And the new empire that is about to fall is America. And we outside here prophesying the destruction that going to come upon that piece of land. Because that is the piece of land that going to be burning from the fire, with fire and with brimstone, from the nuclear missiles and the chariots of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, because of the errors that they're doing in the land. You understand? The errors, taking the Most High rainbow, the covenant which he made with Noah, and making it a symbol for disgusting and violent. You understand? Taking the rainbow of the Lord and making it a symbol for freaking homosexuality, the LGBT community. That in itself, as Apostle Elata has said, if America did everything right and they just do homosexuality, just by that alone they're going to get a shoot. And they did way more than homosexuality. They took the Israelites and killed them on their land. You understand? They took we and put in slavery on their land. They put in slavery down here. You understand? They exceed that sin of homosexuality by far. So it only right that the Most High come and destroy that piece of land. It's only right.
I post a small clip of at least a lot from the main camp. Right? He was saying like in the eye on top of the pyramid. He said that represents a little boy's anus.
A little boy's anus, yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So even there's this he's a senator. Right,
he
always dealing with
religion. This boy, Vice President, former Vice President, Joe Biden. He liked them. You didn't see the video? He had all them little children hugging them up, them little girls caressing them up.
Yeah.
Because I hope vile is. Some of them again, Isaiah 32. That's that from 5. I hope vile he saw is. He saw just this. This beast that come out of a cave and was given a kingdom. And look at what he do with it in 500 years. The Gadites was here for 1500 years prior to, and it still had trees, it had natural resources that could I get from the land. 1500 years the Gadites and the Reubenites was here before you. You understand? And they was doing everything normal. Everything was working normal in perfection. You come in 500 years and we're trading. But then you just class yourself as God's chosen people.
This is Isaiah chapter 32, verse 5. The vile person shall be no more called liberal, nor the churl said to the bountiful.
Said to be bountiful. So vile person and the churl, you know, is a churl a freaking like a woman?
Peasant.
Like a peasant. There's a churl. That Esau are talking about him. He won't be said to be called liberal, nor the churl said to be bountiful, because right now he looking like he's bountiful. But the day's coming when that ain't going to happen. You understand? Go ahead.
It says, the heart also of the rash shall understand knowledge, and the tongue of the stammerers shall be ready to speak plainly.
Right.
The vile person shall be no more. I know someone here. Or evil sex out here. Except for the vile person will speak villainy, and his heart will work iniquity to practice hypocrisy.
So that Esau, that's what he does do. He does speak villainy. He's a villain to the Most High. That's what he does do. God is real. But if you talk about God as me, I is your God. You understand that he's villainy? You're speaking villainy. You're speaking things that you ought not. Go ahead.
It says hypocrisy and to utter error against Yahweh.
Against the Lord. You utter error against the Lord. What are the world you create? This is error against the Most High. This is not how the Most High wants the earth to be. But that's a reason why the Most High, when he created the earth in the beginning, he called it Aidan. You understand? He called it Aidan, which is paradise or joy. He didn't want the earth to reach to the state. But you saw all white people brought it to the state. So you know why you want to come and destroy it?
Can't. Because even so, okay, even the Messiah can actually create man to be immortal too.
Can't.
Because you can tell there's a man, Solomon 2 and 23.
Can't.
Created man to be immortal, so the Messiah didn't really do
it. Can't.
Yeah, son, but you know that can happen.
Can't.
Because in the scripture, I think, say that all Most High didn't really create, he has to destroy it.
Right.
Amen.
Right. I read over 6, right? Isaiah 32 and 6, it says, for the vile person will speak villainy, and his heart will work iniquity to practice hypocrisy and to utter error against Yahweh, to make empty the souls of the hungry.
Yeah, we is the hungry. To make empty we souls.
Can
you never feed with the truth? We was hungry for the Lord, but you teach me about Jesus Christ. This fucking devil right here, teach me about that. And you didn't know we the Israelites. You understand? You know Yahweh. You know Yahweh shy because you just put it in your movies. Sometimes you might put Yahweh in these old time movies. You might put somebody might say Yahweh, you know, and whatnot. And when you're going to the Blue Letter Bible, the name of the Lord, just deliberately change it up. Because when I went into it, it does say Yahweh Shawai. When you're going to the Hebrew, it does say Yahweh Shawai because it knows Yahweh Shai. It knows you don't have no Shawai. You understand? Instead of they teach you about Jesus Christ. They teach you that God loves everybody. They teach you that anybody could be saved. Instead of they teach you that we was hungry for the knowledge of the Lord, but they teach you bullshit. You know, the soul was longing for righteousness, it taught us bullshit. They made empty the soul and the hunger.
Yeah. It says to make empty the soul of the hungry, and he will cause the drink of the thirsty to fail.
Cause the drink of the thirsty to fail. You know, the jobs and all you just give us, it's not sufficient. They just give you our work to just pay your bills. Understand? And then we had us fight like crab in a barrel to get food and drink. After we don't see about you. After we don't take care of you, we had to look to take care of yourself. Understand? And then study how we going and eat and drink and whatnot.
Come on.
That one.
Yeah. Come on here. Come on. Right? It says the instruments also of the children are evil.
What is it when I made instrument they are finding chip? That is an evil device you created. You understand? The instrument of the child is evil. The RFID microchip, ultimately, the ultimate instrument to get everybody under a new world order system. That is evil. Like, but these phones and all is evil. Why say by that? You put freaking apps on it, like your Facebook, your Twitter, your WhatsApp. You understand? And it is, what it does do? Give women permission to horn you right in your freaking bed. Because a woman could be texting a man on your instrument or your device. Why is you in she bed? She texting the next man.
Like you in she.
You understand? That's part of your instrument. That's evil.
All who are here, they let them here.
Sending the vagina, the pussy and thing for the next man. Because why you get them these devices?
You could use them with
all these instruments is part of your plan to frick up people on the earth that you're ruling. That is part of your plan. Your TV, you use that for evil. You use all the things that you get to use it for evil. What?
It says the instruments also of the children are evil. He devised wicked devices.
He devised wicked devices. The RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast. That is a wicked device, a device. You understand? You saw how white people devised that device to put the people right hand on their forehead so that you could have them in your control. But
it says he devised wicked devices to destroy the poor. With lying words.
To destroy the poor with lying words. Because you're going to come. You're going to come and say. You're going to come and say that, hey, take the chip is a good thing. You're going to take a step forward into technology. That's a lie. That is a lie. That is not the truth. When you take that chip, the most I say in Revelation 14 and 10, 9 and 10. That you're going to be destroyed. You understand? You're going to be destroyed.
That's
right.
Say, even when the needy speak it right.
Even when we speak it right. We talking right now. We talking lies, we talking bullshit. You understand? It's righteousness we speak it. But your whole main goal is the freaking have us under your subjection. That's your main goal. But you ain't going to get you. Most I say that. You understand? Most I say that.
But say, warn to them that decree unrighteous decrees that right grievousness which they have.
Scripture.
This Isaiah 10 and verse 1. Slightly. Say, warn to them that decree unrighteous decrees. And that right grievousness which they have prescribed.
The decree of righteous decree. To go into what you saw, decree of righteous is a whole long list that will stem from here to here. That's how much unrighteousness in decree on you. That is how much unrighteousness in decree on you. And you know what you do? You do all these wickedness, and then you write a set of laws to protect your ass. You do all these wickedness, and then you try to prescribe laws to protect you from anybody coming to do you back some. But Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, don't care about your constitutional laws. He says he's not respect our persons. So all the things that you do, you're going to have to pay for it. You're going to ultimately have to pay for it. Payments, it must be made. You understand? You must pay for slavery. You must pay for the raping of the women in slavery. You must pay for the poisoning of the air, the poisoning of the water. You must pay for teaching women that they could abort children. You understand? You must pay for the murders that you committed over 110 million. Negroes, so-called Negroes leave Africa and about 10 million reach over here. You understand? 10 million make it over 110. You must pay for the murders of the Gadites and the Reubenites. You must pay for all these things. You must pay for it. That is how the Most High is a fair thing. Scripture saying, 1 Thessalonians 1 and 6. Seeing that there's a righteous thing to the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. You understand? So it's a righteous thing to God. You have to pay for these things. You must pay for these things. Nothing will go unpunished in the eyesight of the Lord. The Most High said, Jeremiah.
Copy separate. These are Psalms 1 and 5, and I'll read from these from 5 to about 14. Say here, remember this marvelous work that I have done, his wonders and his judgment of his mouth. O ye seed of Abraham, his servant, ye children of Jacob, his chosen. He is Yahweh, our power. His judgments are in all the earth. He had remembered his covenant forever, the word which he commanded unto a thousand generations, which covenant he had made with Abraham, and his oath unto Isaac, and confirmed the same law unto Jacob for a law, and Israel for an everlasting covenant, saying unto thee, will I give the land of Canaan the lot of your inheritance, when they were both a few men in number, ye very few, and strangers in it. When they went from one nation to another, from one kingdom to another, he suffered no man to do them wrong. He reproved kings for their sake. Yeah, I mean, Moses reproved kings for their sake. And he really suffered a man to say, recompense has to be there, sure.
Scripture says, whoso touches you, touches the apple of his eye.
God.
So you get Zechariah 2 and 8. If you touch Israel, you touch the apple of the Lord's eye, and that is the most precious thing to somebody. You understand? If you touch, let me say I have a youth man, a son or a daughter, and you come and end up killing my daughter or my son. So I won't recompense that. That is only common sense. I want you to suffer the same way. You make me suffer. You make me suffer, and then I must watch you.